too distant future, Earth's economic systems have collapsed. The Apollo space program is resurrected to search out a means of preserving mankind. Secretly, a lunar base is built to launch ships large enough to carry entire nations of settlers into a vast unknown in search of habitable planets. Floating aircraft carriers in the troposphere serve as storage for the terrestrial airships that deliver cargo, supplies, and building materials. It is here, in a pressurized storage compartment, modified to serve as a contemporary Noah's Ark, that the fate of humanity is sealed. Exploring the makeshift menagerie with a stolen pass on the eve of a lunar cargo run, an adventurous pilot ventures too close to the cage marked Canis Lupus. Not wishing to draw attention to his trespass, the pilot hides his injury and leaves on his cargo mission. As he observes the moon's pale form come from behind the Earth's shadow, he begins to feel a horrific change coming over his body.
Two dark and wicked sisters escape their mountain tomb, seeking retribution on those who sought their doom. One, the Queen of Sorrows, with carnations in her hair, presents both love and beauty, which I assure you are not there. Instead, betrayal, hate, and anger fill her blackened heart. Cruelty, inhumanity, and torture are her art. She'll call to you with siren's song and lead you into night. She'll take your mind, your heart, soul, and finally your life. Lurking in the darkness, in a dress of darkest black, a curse upon her lips, and a knife behind her back. She hides from hawk and master, lady of the light. She spreads disease, disaster, creating wrong from right. The lady will not rest until the ravens nevermore, from drowning arrow through the chest, or hanging from a cord, from a cord, from a cord.
Oh,
year is 2064. An archaeologist exploring a previously undiscovered burial chamber in an elaborate Egyptian tomb discovers the Book of Thoth, an ancient Egyptian tome rumored to have been handed down to the people from the gods themselves. Within its pages lie the secrets of powerful magic. Man learns to communicate with the gods, and soon comes to control them, following a long and destructive war. Man prevails through sheer number and force. We soon discover, however, that this power is no reward. When everything may be an illusion, what can truly be real?
Amen. together.